This
we
conference will now be recorded.
So there was one thing, resource super time. We'll be discussing that one. Then the page properties, and then the IPARSIS. That what is the inherited paragraph system and how we can implement, and like what is the difference between design dialogue and IPARSIS. Okay, so let me just first open the page, and then we'll see that how we what are the page properties and all. I'm going to my classic UI first. So if you notice here that there is page properties which is coming as of now disabled. Why it is coming disabled? Because the page component which I'm using to create this template is not having any dialogue. Okay, because any component have any dialogue associated, because this component is having a dialogue, this component is having a dialogue, but my page component, we haven't created any dialogue for that. Okay, so let's see if we create a dialogue for our parent, like our page component. Okay, then we'll see that what will happen with this disabled page properties. So let's go back to your like apps folder. Then you see here page component. So we created this page component to create a template. Okay, and which was having my sidekick and which was having the client library as well as the paragraph system. Okay, but here you notice that we haven't created any dialogue. Okay, so suppose I create a dialogue for this page component. Okay, let me just close all these first. Okay, this was our page component where we included the libraries and all. So I'll do one thing, I just create a dialogue here. Okay, and then just create a simple field, like text field, just create one text field inside the tab one. Just right click, create note items widget collection, okay. So what I'm doing, I'm just creating a field in the dialog, and I'm just giving one like name and other properties to this text field. And then save all. Now just refresh the page. Now you see, because that is my page component, so from where we can open the dialog of my page component. Okay, because these all are my global components which I put on that page component. To open the dialog for page component, we can open that using page properties. Okay, because the page component is associated with a template, and then template is used to create the page. Okay, so if we click on page properties, then my dialog would render. Okay, so this is my page component dialog, the page properties. Okay, if you are not having that any dialogue in your page component, then this would be disabled mode. Okay, now let's suppose I press some I give in some value here, like this is my page property dialog. Just click OK. Okay, just go back to this page in CRX. Okay, so you will notice one thing. If you just scroll it up a bit, then you will notice that the values which I am giving for a dialog, okay, for page properties, are saving on the page itself. Okay, this is my English page, and as per the rule, every page should be having one GCR colon content node. Okay, if you check, if you click on GCR colon content node, you will see text field property. Okay, so whatever value I give in for this component, for this page component, or to this page property, are saving on the page property, are saving on the page only, okay, instead of nodes, because my component, my page component, is associated only to this page. Okay, so that's why my page properties are saving on this JCR content node. Okay, now see, normally what we do is, to access the properties, we write properties dot whatever the property name. Okay, now my page property is saving on the page level only. Okay, these are the components only, like global components, and earlier properties were saving here only, like for urban accordion my title is saving here, and for all of these were saving on the node itself, but for page component it's storing on my page level. Okay, so now if I want to access this property text field, how I can access it? So there are many implicit objects in CQ. So we have already seen the properties one. We have just seen properties. The second implicit object which AM provide is page properties. Okay, so now just open any any component, like this urban text component, open the JSP. Now I want to invoke that page property. So how I would invoke? So instead of property, I would just write page properties dot get. Text field, whatever the property name. Okay, I just refresh it. Okay, so now you can see here page property. This is my page property dialog. So whatever value you have given here in this page property, okay, if you change here 1, 2, 3 and click OK, so it will be reflecting here. So now the thing is that why we need the page property, and what kind of values we can provide in the page property dialog. Okay, so normally what happens, we do not create any dialog for our pages or for our page component. What we do, we generally inherit, we inherit the dialogs from the super type, okay, or you can say from the library. So what is the benefit of creating like your custom dialog or inheriting, I will be showing you. So now there is one property, might be you observed that when we were creating the components. Okay, let me just create one thing, create and create component. So you've seen one property, that is super type. Okay, so what super type does is, it inherits the dialog properties, and it inherit the files as well. Okay, suppose in this page component, while creating this page component, I provided one sling colon resource super type property. Okay, like this, create component, and I provided some value here. Okay, like lips foundation page. Lips foundation components and page. So this is my library page component. Okay, I just copied this path, paste here. You just go to the page component which is exist in your library. Okay, so you will see there are lots of files are there, and there are some CQ dialog and dialog as well. Okay, now I want to inherit this page component in my application page component or in my website page component. So what I will do, I will just copy this path. Okay, so we'll see that what is the benefit of inheritance. I'm just copying this path. Now I want to inherit this page component. I want that some of the functionality or the dialog should be available to my page component. So I will do the inherit. How I can do the inherit? I just copied this path, page component, which is a part of library. I went to my page component. Okay, first I'm deleting my dialog which I just created. Just delete it, save all, and remove this property from here. Now, because we have already created the component, so it's not like that I will be creating a component again. Okay, so instead of doing that, you can just add the property which is equivalent to resource super type, like sling colon resource super type. So that property got created when you give any value in this box, like when you create any component and give something in this box super type, so it will be saving as a sling colon resource super type. Okay, so you can check that as well and give the value here. And one thing that we ignore this absolute path. Whenever you give in resource type or resource super type, we should ignore slash lib slash or slash app slash. We should be giving only the relative path. Just add it. Sorry, I was yeah, I need to here. Okay, just add it. Save all. Okay, so what I did, I just simply provided one property, sling colon resource super type. Okay, while creating the component. Now just refresh your page. And if you click off page properties, then you will see one dialogue is getting inherited. Okay, dialogue is coming. Okay, so this dialogue is coming because we provided one like sling resource super type. So my component is inheriting the dialogue. So what sling does is, sling go to this component. If it finds that it is having the dialogue node, that is fine. Otherwise it will go to this resource super type. Okay, and it will inherit the dialogue, or and it will show dialogue here. So now what is the use of this page property dialogue? So the thing is that whenever you create any AEM site, so there might be some configuration related to the cloud, or if you are creating the some blueprints or live copies, you need to sync with your live copies. Okay, like to roll out some changes, or there might be the requirement that you need to provide some metadata or some descriptions. Like if you go here, more title and description. So for SEO purposes, we need to provide these details, like navigation title, which can be useful in the breadcrumb. Okay, so there are many things like vanity URL for your page. You can create, you can give the vanity URL as well. In advanced section, if you go, if any redirect things you want to give, so many things. These are the out of box like dialogue, which is giving you a facility to provide some thumbnail images for your page and to connect with the cloud services as well. Okay, so instead of like doing all these things manually or creating the dialogue, inheritance provide you a facility where you can reuse the content. Okay, so instead of creating this dialogue again and again for every page component, you can simply inherit the dialogue. Okay, and you can make use of it. We'll see that how we can configure the cloud services and the blueprint and live copy. So I'll be keeping one session for this blueprint and live copy, that how we can create the blueprints and live copies and how we can configure this cloud services. Okay, so for those purposes we use this dialog. Okay, and we can also customize the dialog. Like if you want to add something, then what we'll do, we'll just copy the dialog from our libs, and we can extend it, or we can add whatever we want to do it. That is called overlaying. Overlay means like if something exists in library, okay, you want to make some changes on it. So what you normally do, you go to the library. Okay, suppose, let me just give you an example of overlay as well. So this is inheritance. Okay, the overlay, what is overlaying is, these are my foundation component. Okay, now you want to make some changes, or you want some text component. Okay, so you can copy this component, this text component, paste in your apps folder. Okay, apps, urban, or here, and you can modify something in the dialog. Okay, so that is called an overlaying, that you have, instead of changing in the library, you are just overlaying that component. You are copying the component in apps, and then you are changing something, because it is not recommended to change anything in the library. Okay, so that's about the page properties. We'll see these things later on when we'll be discussing the MSM, okay, multi-site management console or blueprints and all. Okay, so now the thing is, one more thing is there. Let me just show. There is one more thing, that is dialog inheritance. We have seen, but there might be the cases that suppose I have created one dialog here in my urban accordion, okay, in this component. And let me just open it. It's having only one tab. Just give me a moment.
Bipin, I have one question. The use of Sling resource super type, is it only on a use case where we can use this one, or there are other use cases also?
There are other use cases also. Dialog is one, and one another is the files. Okay, suppose there are some files. Okay, like let me just give. Suppose you provided for this component, urban text, Sling resource type, this one, urban jQuery accordion. Okay, let me do one thing. I am providing Sling resource type here. Okay, and I am giving the path for this component. Okay, so what I did, I made the parent, or I inherited this urban text component from urban jQuery. Okay, now suppose my component is having two files here, so it can inherit the files as well, like urban inherit .jsp. Okay, suppose I have written some logic in urban inherit.jsp. okay, suppose you have written some custom code in this file, which is applicable for this component, and it's having some global functionality. Now you want to reuse this file. So instead of copy paste the file here, like create another file and writing that functionality, you can inherit that file as well. So what you need to do is simply, you just provide the Sling resource super type here. Okay, whatever the component you are inheriting, and you just include the file using this syntax, cq colon include. Okay, and like this one, script equals to, sorry, script in this one, let me just copy this file as well line, otherwise it will throw an error. Script equals to whatever the file name. So now what will happen, I will just show you. If you refresh this page, Sorry, I written in wrong file. I need to copy paste from here, and I need to provide in urban text. I written in some different file. Okay, just paste here and just refresh. Okay, now you can see this is my urban inherit file. Whatever content I retain in some of the file. So what will happen at the runtime? Okay, I've included double. That's fine. Okay, so what will happen when Sling? I requested this component. Okay, urban text. So it will try to find script urban inherit.jsp inside this folder only, inside this component. It doesn't find here. Sling doesn't find this file here because this doesn't exist. I haven't given any path here like slash app. So Sling will be finding this file inside this one. Okay, because we have given one property here, Sling colon resource super type. So it will go to that resource type and it will resolve that file. Okay, so basically two things are there for that Sling colon resource super type. Mainly for the inheritance, and we can inherit the dialog as well as the script files in the page component when we'll be creating a proper structure. Okay, then we'll see that what is the actual use of the inheritance or how practically we can like inherit the files. Okay, so that's a example which I given just here. If I just remove this one, then it should throw me an error. Okay, or not throw error, it will not, it should not include anything because it will not be finding that one. Now you can see that it is throwing me an error because could not find a script urban inherit.jsp. Okay, by because I haven't provided any Sling resource super type or any inheritance, I haven't provided. So Sling will come here, it will try to find this JSP. It doesn't find it, so it will throw an error. If you have defined Sling resource super type of, it means that your component is inherited using some other component, it will go to that component and it will try to resolve this path, resolve this file. If it finds, then it will just render, otherwise it will throw an error.
We can use only Sling resource type here, or we cannot in place of Sling resource super type. If we will use all, if we will use only Sling resource type, so it will not work, or it will
no,
work.
No, it should not work because if you are giving Sling resource type, normally what we do while creating the templates, we provide this resource type. But there is no way, like you can do the customization. If I provide here resource type, then ideally it should not work because what you are doing that you are trying to like break the whatever the CQ provides that you should use Sling resource type while creating the template and resource super type if you want to inherit the component. If you want to include the files, you can directly include it here, but I haven't tried that. If you provide the resource type here, let's just try resource type or something, but it should not work.
Okay, that is only for component template level.
Yeah, only for template level we use the Sling resource type, and for component level, if you want to achieve the inheritance, then we use Sling colon resource super type. So there are two different things. Okay, it doesn't work, so we have to provide Sling resource super type only.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, fine. So now what I was saying, that suppose there is one case. Let me just delete this file first. Okay. I have created some dialog, okay, which is having some typical structure or which is having one image tab there. Because in urban text component, if I go here, let me just refresh it. So this is my text. If I open the dialog, then there are two tabs. One is tab one and second one is image. So now suppose in one of my component, or let me just drag one component here. That is banner. Okay, so suppose in this banner component I want this image tab as well. Okay, so what normally I will do, I will go to my urban banner component. Okay, the same way dialog here, and I will create another tab for my image, and I will be writing all the properties and all. Suppose your tab is having 10 or 20 multi fields, then that would be rework. Okay, because if you want, if you know that the same thing exists on some different component, okay, so instead of creating that tab or those dialog, you can inherit that dialog as well. Okay, so how you can inherit or how you can include the dialog? You cannot say inherit, but that means that you are including something from some different component. Okay, let me just give you an example, then it will be more clear. Now my use case is that I am having a component urban text, and it's having two tabs, tab one and image. Now I want image tab to be part of my urban banner. Okay, so how I can include this image inside this urban banner? So what we need to do is just click here items, right click, create a node. Just create any node here. I am creating a node like img, and the type would be CQ widget. Just click OK, save all. And here we need to provide one, there is one special X type, that is CQ include. Okay, so just type here X type CQ include add, and one more thing, the path. So what path I will be giving? So this is my urban text component. I want this path, this tab to be part of my component. So if I open this path, okay, and let me just do one thing here, just type path. And write one thing here, infinity. I will be telling what is this infinity, not JSON. And save all. Okay, now just refresh your page. So now if you check the dialog of your banner one, you will see that you can drag and drop, or you can use the image tab of different component instead of like creating all the properties here. What you can do, you can refer the dialog, because there might be the cases that you are having some complex dialog which is having 20-30 X types in certain tabs. Like this is my tab and it's having 20-30 X types, multi fields are there and all, and we don't, and that functionality is same, we have already developed for one component. Now we want that functionality to be part of our component. Okay, so instead of creating or copy paste here on your dialog, what you can do, you can use a special X type, that is CQ include. Okay, and in the path, what you need to give is, if you noticed one thing, I give in the path, but here I written infinity.json. Okay, so what this mean, like what is infinity.json? So if I copy this path, okay, let me just copy this path. So as I said in the Sling API, Sling like it is a REST based. Okay, so what I will do now, I will just go to, sorry, my instance is restarting, I guess. Let me just start my instance first. This is 504. Okay. My instance got it stopped, so I need to restart it. We'll see that why we should like start our instance using in debug mode. In next to next session, we'll start on CI/CD and WCM. And then we'll see that what is the actual use of create or starting your instance in debug mode when we'll be writing some Java functionality. Okay, so let it start first. So meanwhile, I will just show you one thing to you. So now this is a very simple template, or I just downloaded it from the net. So these are the sample HTML templates, which is having a bootstrap and like jQuery, and there are some different libraries are there. Okay, like if I open the assets or something, so there are some integrations for Scala or jQuery. Okay, so what we will be doing that we'll try to like implement this thing. Okay sir, so after we go to the Sitely, we'll see that how we can create this kind of simple website from scratch in the Sitely in the touch UI only. Okay, so like in the home we see like some banners are there and some components are present, how to create the header, footer and all. So we'll see this thing first. Let me just see whether it got opened or not. It is still running. Okay, so we'll see that how we can define the structure of an EM website. Okay, where to keep the header, footer and where to keep these components. Okay, we'll see when we are covered with the Sitely part. Sitely and some touch UI basics we'll create in the touch UI. I'm not going to cover this thing in the classic UI. We'll do this thing in touch. Okay, so
can we add also one carousel component there?
Yeah, we can add that one, no issues. You can add any component, so you can create any component. We can take an example of carousel as well. We can easily make it with like multi-field component. There is no issue. We'll see. Okay, so now let me just hit this URL. So now you see one thing here. If you notice here, I appended one infinity.json. Okay, so this was the path of my dialog tab. Okay, slash app slash urban components urban text dialog. Whatever the path of my like in the urban text, this was my path of my image tab. Okay, I opened here and I written two things here, infinity.json. So as I mentioned in Sling one, that we are having three renders. One is JSON, XML and HTML. Okay, Sling is based on the REST and REST is providing me these three things. Okay, so what infinity does, it takes the whole JSON output of that of your node. Okay, if I write here like one, it will not be having any like sub nodes or something. Okay, so we write here infinity. If you want the full JSON representation of your node, you just write infinity.json. okay, let me give you another example. Suppose this is my page. Okay, and I write here and I provide here JSON. It is giving me the current node JSON only. If I write here dot one dot, it will give me till one node. Okay, if I give here infinity, then it will give me the whole JSON of this English node. Okay, so hope it is clear to you that why we are using infinity.json. Okay, so by referring this path, like let me just go back where we were. So we were here, we used two things. One was X type, that would always be CQ include, and the second one is a path. That's what path you want to include in your component, and we need to mention infinity.json. Okay, so that is again Sling comes in picture here. It takes the JSON and it binds to our component. Okay, so that's an important thing, that sometime we use this CQ include thing. We should be aware that what is the infinity.json, how we can include the other. But the one thing is that we cannot include the properties of a dialog. If you want that, I want to include some of the properties of some tab, you cannot do that with this CQ include. You can only include the tabs. Okay, so that was the thing for CQ include. There is one more important thing. Let me just open the document. What is left? Page properties we have covered. Touch UI will be covering, might be tomorrow or something. Okay, so there was one thing which I haven't told that. Let me just explain that. So what is the there is one more thing, iParses, inherited paragraph system. So till now what we did, we created only paragraph system. We were dragging and dropping our components in the paragraph system. Now see one scenario. So let me just close these things first. So we created two pages for our site. Let me just open these two pages. Then we'll see that what is the need of creating a inherited paragraph system and what is the benefit. Let me just open the other page as well. And both pages are created using the same template. Okay, because we created only one template. So as of now. So if you notice one thing, you will be noticing here in design dialog. Okay, let me just go back to design. If I change anything in my design dialog component, it will be reflecting on all the templates. Okay, on all the pages which are using that template. Okay, I change on this page the value 1, 2, 3, 4, and if I refresh this page, it is reflecting 1, 2, 3, 4. So now let me do one thing. I'll be creating another template. First, I'm creating a new page component. Let me just give an example here. I'm creating a new page component. Okay. So I am writing here urban, and you give you name product page component. Okay, group, we do not provide any group for our page component. Just click next and okay, just save it now in the GSP. Just delete this one and include the paragraph system only. First, I am telling I am just using the paragraph system only. Okay, just copy these three lines and paste here and do nothing. Okay, I'm including a paragraph system only. Now I'm creating another template using this urban base, urban product page component. Copy this path, go to template, create a new template. You can write here anything like carbon product page template. Just give the path of resource. Better if you can ignore these apps. Okay. Just provide ranking one. Next, allowed path slash content, then dot star, then question mark. Next. I am skipping these two things, allowed children and allowed parents. So I will be telling what are these. Just save all. Now just go back to your site admin. Just refresh it. Okay, go to the urban website inside, or go to the EN. Now create one page. Okay, new page. Give any name here. I am giving like a product, and choose this template which we recently created, urban product page template, and create. Okay, now just open this page which you newly created. Open in CF hash mode. Yeah, definitely it will come. So to make components available, we need to go to the design mode first. Click edit and choose your urban. Just click OK and go back to edit mode. Okay, so now what I will be doing here, I'll be just dragging the component design, urban design component, because we seen here that when we were changing something, it was reflecting on the pages. Okay, in rest of the pages it was reflecting. So same way it should reflect here. We'll see whether it is really reflecting or not, urban design component. Now you see it is not reflecting in on this page. Okay, now let me do one thing. I will create another page inside EN. I'm writing it EN like subproduct. And I'm using different template. Okay, urban based template only I'm using now. Create. Open this subproduct page as well. CF hash. Now do the same thing. Okay, just go to urban and drag this urban design component. So now might be you noticed one thing here, that whatever the pages I created using the base template, values are reflecting, like welcome to design 1 2 3 4, whatever value I provided for this component, it's reflecting on this template, on this page subproduct, but these are not reflecting on product. Okay, so why? Because a design dialog values save on a template basis, not. Okay, if I created a different template, then value of my design dialog won't be persisting for that template, correct? So to persist our values, like there are cases when you are creating any website. Okay, so it's not like you will be having only one template. Okay, now let me give you an example. Suppose I am having one flipkart.com or any. Okay, so this is my website and this is my logo. Okay, suppose you have created this website in EM. So there might be the cases that you are not using a single template. You might be using 10 templates, or you might be using 5 templates or 6 templates. Okay, that depends on your requirement. So what will happen if we use the design dialog, that it is bind to the template level only. Okay, like for this page, if we keep our logo in one template design dialog, that is fine. But for the next page, if I created and I'm not using the same template, my logo won't be appearing. It won't be persisting on the other pages which are using different templates. Correct. So just give me a moment. Sorry. So now you consider this component as a logo component, Urban Design. Okay, that's fine for these three pages which I created as a simple template. But if I create a new template, then these values are not persisting. Correct. So now what is the alternative to achieve this thing? So there is one thing, that is IPARSIS, inherited paragraph system. Okay. So now we'll see that what is the inherited paragraph system and how we can achieve the things which cannot be delivered by that design dialog. Okay. So, or you can say the paragraph system, it works in a different way. You cannot compare design dialog and IPARSIS, but the things which are not possible using design dialog, or if you want to persist your changes across the templates, okay, that's not bound to a template. So you seen here that if I created a subproduct page using some different template, it is persisting. But if I create another page using some different template, it's not persisting here in case of design dialog. Okay, so that's the like very basic thing of a design dialog. We have covered almost all things for design dialog. Now we'll see that how we can create the inherited paragraph system. Okay, so what I will be doing now, I will just go back to my page component. Okay, first I'm deleting these things. Okay, and then it will be confusing for you. Or let me do one thing, just close these pages what you created so far. Go to your site admin, okay, and just delete these two pages. We don't need to delete that one, we'll change that one. Just delete this page, product page, and delete this subproduct page. Okay, now what I will do, I have just created one page component. And instead of giving parses paragraph system, I'm writing here IPARSIS, inherited paragraph system. Okay, and the rest of the things are same. I'm keeping same. Rest of the things would be same. Okay, so now what I will be doing here in the template one, product page template. Okay, so the path and everything will be same. I just included IPARSIS instead of paragraph system. So now just save it and create the pages again. First I will create a hierarchy inside ES. Okay, so I will just click this Urban website. I will create a new page. Okay, so just create a page like you can create it for Spanish. Okay, I'm Spanish using this Urban product based template which is having an IPARSIS, okay, inherited paragraph system. I just click create. Okay, now what I want to do, just double click this one. Open in CFH mode. Okay, so you will see here one like this bar, edit bar is there, and it is saying inherited paragraphs. So what does it mean? We'll see actually what it is. For the timing, what I'm doing, I'm just dragging one drag one simple text component. Okay, Urban text component I'm dragging inside this inherited paragraph system. Okay, and giving some values here, value one, text one, something just click OK. Okay, so it's rendering something. That's fine. Now, what we will do? We'll create another page inside ES. Okay. I'm writing a product and product using same template. Just click create. Open this product page. Write here CF hash. So now, if you notice one thing here, I created my product page, okay? But this component, whatever the inherited one, like urban text text one value, is coming by default, okay? This is coming because I kept. So you just consider this thing. So these things we can remove because I keep the same name like par. This is coming here, urban text value. So that is similar to the design dialog. Nothing change. Now what I will do, I will just create one more template. Okay. So now exactly the things are same. The whatever we achieved using design dialog, we can achieve using this inherited paragraph system. Now the difference you will see now. Okay. What I will do, I will just create another template. Actually, sometimes it's like hard to understand the IPARSIS concept, but once we go through this concept, we'll see. Okay, so I'm going to page, create another component. Okay, I'm writing here like urban subproduct. Create, click next and press OK. Just save all. Now open the script. Urban page, control E and control V. So first let me do one thing. I will go to the content and we'll see that how IPARSIS values are getting saved. Let me first quickly create one more template here, then we'll see. I'm writing here urban subproduct page template. Okay, this is the path of my new. Next, okay, just save all. Okay, so just go back first to the content. Okay, slash content. Go to your site which we created, urban site. Just refresh it once. So you see we created Spanish using that inherited paragraph system. Just navigate to JCA content and par. Okay, so that was my IPARSIS inherited paragraph system. That is fine. Now navigate to product page, JCA content. So you won't see any paragraph system there. Okay, so what it does it, if you put if you created any page, any sub page, any child page using the same template, the node will not be created. That inherited paragraph system or the paragraph will not be included in the sub pages which you have created using same template because you are using inheritance. If you have created a page, okay, using some templates, okay, and then you are creating some child pages, then this node par urban text will not be creating here. Okay, so it will be inheriting the paragraphs. Okay, so that is the meaning of inheriting paragraphs. Okay, so like because now it is persisting the values, whatever in the paragraph system was there, it is inheriting in the product piece as well. Correct. So that is the inherited paragraph system, because if you see this structure English, and if I create another page inside the English, it will be having this paragraph node. Okay, because that is not inherited. So inheritance in the nature of the IPARSIS. Okay, as the name suggests, IPARSIS. So this page, Spanish page, is having one IPARSIS. Okay, once it is you define IPARSIS for any page and you create a child page, it won't be creating this node under that child page. It will inherit that paragraph system. Okay, so that is the inheritance paragraph system. Now let me just explain that what we can achieve using the different template. So what I did here, I just created another template. Okay, and the most important thing which we need to remember, then if you are creating a new template and you are giving the same path variable par, okay, and the same IPARSIS, then it will inherit from my parent page as well if you are creating a new template. Okay, so now what will happen? Now I just created one new page component and new page template, and I given the same name for my inherited paragraph system. Okay, now you can correlate it with the design dialog where we created a new template and the values were not reflecting. In the case of inherited paragraph system, we created new page component, but we kept the same name, same paragraph system. Okay, if I change paragraph one here, then my changes will not be appearing on the pages which will be using this page component or this page template. Okay, I'm keeping the same paragraph name. Now what I will do, I will just go back to here. I will create another page. Okay, I will be giving it a name, subproduct page. Okay, now what I will do, product. Okay, I am selecting subproduct page template. Okay, just correlated with the design dialog where we created a new template and new component, my changes was not reflecting. Now I have created a separate template, separate component for IPARSIS, but I kept the same name par paragraph for my IPARSIS. Now I am just using urban subproduct page template and click create. So now you will see the difference. Now just click on subproduct. CFH. So might be you observe one thing here, that values are persisting here, value one and text one. Why it is persisting? We need to just check it. Just go back to your content. Okay, so this is my urban site. Just refresh it. Spanish, then product and subproduct. You will not notice any paragraph system PAR, okay, because it is inheriting from my parent page. Okay, this paragraph system is inheriting. I included in my page component. This is my subproduct page. Okay, let me just navigate. This is my subproduct page which I created, and it is using one this resource type, urban subproduct page component. This one, ideally it should be including this paragraph system here, like it should be creating one node par and then it should include whatever the components are there. But this is the functionality of inherited paragraph system. It checks whether in your parent page there is a already existing paragraph. If it finds that, yeah, on my parent page. So what is the parent page? This page is Spanish. It will go to the Spanish page. It will check whether my parent page is having any paragraph with the same name. Yes, it is having a paragraph system, so that it won't be creating any paragraph inside it. It will inherit this paragraph system. So whatever you have put in that paragraph system, you can easily see on your pages or sub pages. If you keep the logo there, then you can see the logo, okay, on across the pages or across the templates. If you are following the same name, like same paragraph system on all of your templates. So while creating the structure of a website, we keep it in mind that if we are placing a logo, then I will be creating all of my templates using some same paragraph system, same IPARSIS. Okay, so you just practice whatever I told. Might be first time you won't be getting it. You just see that how to what is the difference between a design dialog? You create 2 to 3 templates for design dialog, different, then create the same way in case of IPRCs. You will feel the difference, that what is the actual difference is. Okay, so Tamiz, have you got this one, or you have any confusion in this IPRCs and design dialog, that why we choose that IPRCs one?
Hi, when I am able to understand, I will work and I will let you know.
Yeah. You just go through these concepts first, that how we can, what is the like IPRCs and like how we can implement. Just go through this video and try to implement. And if you have any query, then we will discuss it tomorrow.
Yeah, same here, Bipin. I understood, but I need to implement that.
Yeah. Just try to implement, because this is the like concept of normally we forgot. We just remember one thing, that inherited paragraph system is like something which inherits the like components in the pages. But when we come to the implementation part, then we have to logically think that where I can make maximum use of this inherited paragraph system, in which scenario I can use it. Okay, so you first try on your own that to implement. Just try to implement inherited paragraph system, and then we'll see that what is the use case. I have given one use case of logo. We'll see more things. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, Vipin. And Vipin, Parsis and Pardbase are same?
Sorry?
Pardbase. Is there anything called Pardbase?
Yeah, actually in previous 5.5, 5.6, we were using the Pardbase. Okay. Instead of giving the path of my page component, we were giving the Pardbase path. Okay, there are some differences. I will let you know. Because nowadays we do not use that Pardbase. That is internally my page component will be using that Pardbase. But normally what we do, we refer to page component either in the WCM foundation or either in the foundation only. For Sitely, we use the WCM page component, or for classic UI or JSP, we normally use the page component. I will let you know that what is the actual difference, but I haven't used that Pardbase. I can let you know that what is the difference between Pardbase and this page component.
Okay. Yeah, it's fine. Okay,
Tamil and Tamiz, then I will be sending the documents to you. I created a task as well. So you just go through that and we'll meet tomorrow. Okay.
Did you send that jQuery thing yesterday?
I have uploaded everything. So I have created some folders there. So you can get from those folders.
Okay.
I have uploaded all the 3 HTMLs. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thanks. I meet you tomorrow.
Thank you.
Thank you.